W6 do it today.
Kazzy, thank you. 25 years ago, three young lads would go on to write one of the most infectious pop songs of a generation.
Two and a half decades, Hanson has continued to create catchy tunes like Where's the Love, Give a Little, and their latest one, it's called Child at Heart.
What happens when you try and grab the drumsticks? Well, most bands never stand a chance of staying together so long. The Hanson brothers are still at the top of their game, performing to sellout crowds right around the country and the world and the universe.
And they were just giving each other a hard time there. They're laughing at you.
This video is very much a character story, and in the story, the main character that I'm sort of playing really gets beat up. I mean, he looks like bruised literally. And bloody.
Gets in
and
a
so
car
just, and here's this Pop Diddy, and here's Taylor. Wow, these 30 years have really won it hard. 30 years in, it's looking rough.
Isaac, so you're right into this tour, this national tour here in Australia. How are the concerts going? Because these fans have been here all morning.
Yeah,
amazing.
I mean, we had solo shows in Perth, and that was the beginning. And, you know, we got shows all over the country, Brisbane, here in Sydney.
Adelaide, Melbourne.
I mean, it's
great. Make it to New Zealand at the final show.
It feels really, like, just special. Like, people, they've been separated so long that there's this energy that's kind of a step up from anything you've experienced before, where we're just so ready to be back together.
We've been separated for pretty much 200 years.
You guys have a different level of separation. Last time we were touring, we did a symphony tour, which was an amazing thing. We'd had a project playing with orchestras. We played the Sydney Opera House, which is incredible. Yeah. But, I mean, look, the connection with fans is always more than a pop song or a moment. It's the community that keeps you coming back. And I think with fans, with one another, I think we hear that. You know, they're connected to each other. Yeah. So it's like you get to travel the world hosting the party.
Yeah. But a lot of bands don't like coming here because we are so far away.
But you've been good to us.
Yeah, no,
you've been good
I mean,
to
we
us.
We don't like the jet lag.
Yeah. The problem is, right when we're ready to leave, we finally get Justin. But no, the Aussie fans have been amazing to us.
You guys, absolutely,
we've felt the love from the beginning, from our first tour 25 years ago, to the fans that are coming out tonight. So we just appreciate that they're still joining us.
Yeah. We're just not sure who's there for us, who's there for you, but we'll work it out.
I can tell you that.
You performed earlier this morning on Sunrise. Your fans, as we said, still outside. One lovely lady who has followed you from the U.S.
Right.
Because you're doing shows in the U.S., right?
Oh, we just did about 50. 40.
Yeah. But she gets on a plane and comes here to see you guys here. That must mean a lot.
It's amazing.
We've seen this amazing thing happen where fans connect. You know, over the internet and meeting people, and then they become friends and they sort of come to share almost these like family reunion type experiences. I'm gonna go to Australia and tour with my best friend there. Go on the tour with the band.
One of the things too, we started our own record company after our second record and went independent, have been now independent again, much longer than we ever signed to a major. And I think one of the things we talk about is we bet on the fans, you know, on the true fans, not just, and so I think that sense of community, that sense of traveling to see shows, seeing more than one show.
Well, we change the set list a lot from night to night. We change the set list a lot. And so And so that's a big part of why people will come to multiple shows, because they'll see like the two shows in Perth were very different, actually. So it's kind of get the experience of you never know exactly what you're going to get. And I think that's an important part of
it. We don't know what we're going to get. Yeah. Sometimes we'll perform well,
sometimes it'll sound terrible.
Why do you change that? Is to keep yourselves interested?
Everything, the audience that's going to come to multiple shows, and then too, like, every night is its own experience. I mean, you have certain songs, and we were proud to play songs like Umbop and Penny and Me and Where's the Love, but every night's like you're trying to create an experience that you have excitement for as well.
So you got to remember, we've been a band for 30 years. You only play maybe 22 to 25 songs a night, so to get to all those 200 songs, you really have to change it so you can play all the songs people want to hear.
Okay, siblings hanging out together for three decades. Yeah. I've got sisters and I adore them, but a four-hour lunch is fine, right?
That's how our sisters feel about us.
Hanging out for 30 years and on the road together, high stress, deadlines, timelines, everything going on.
It's a lot. I mean, I don't think it's... Like, it's much like having, as much as it sounds funny, having a marriage. You know, you have a common connection, and then every day is not, you know, always perfect. But, you know, with us, I think we have a common bond, which is music, and we have something that we're really proud of, like something that we regard as worthy of kind of holding on to. And then also you try and give each other space. I mean, this new record's called Red, Green, Blue, because essentially it's three projects in one. Each one of us took five songs and sort of said, these are the songs we're going to write.
Right.
These are the songs I'm going to produce this way. And so it was just, you know, having that sense of respect for one another, but also realizing that you're not the same. I mean, we're very different. Just look at the way we dress. I mean, everything about us is we take on the world differently. But I think, you know, that's what it makes a band work.
Sure.
You don't have two drummers and two guitar players and two, you know, everybody does their own thing.
You and Michael Bublé are probably the only, like, pop stars.
Isaac doesn't actually own any suits. Isaac only has suits. He doesn't have any shorts.
But he would probably love to just do classics all the time.
That would be kind of fun. I like that idea.
What are you guys doing for Thanksgiving? Are you home in time? Because I know
Thanksgiving is the start of the Christmas season for the Americans. Yeah, and everybody gets together. I mean, lots of food, then lots of sleeping after that.
Because you're 20, you have other siblings. There are 23 kids.
23 grandkids, we're the oldest, three of seven. So it's a big party. I mean, we go to our mom's house, and it's food everywhere and about 27 pies.
And it's a lot of volume.
Lots of,
because mom's got the biggest house that can manage it?
No, actually, she has the smallest house, but we go to mom's house because it's mom's house.
Traditions die hard.
You're coming over.
I think dad is like, wait, we need a bigger house.
No, that's where everybody goes outside. You know, like you.
That's true, actually.
Dad says that after you've done a successful world tour. Like, come on, boy. Guys, lovely to see you. We love talking to you on the satellite regularly, and it's nice to see you here in person. Enjoy us. Thanks for coming in. Hanson has shows in Adelaide, Brisbane, and Melbourne with very limited tickets left. If you'd like to check the boys out, head to frontiertouring.com.
Thanks, guys. We'll soon for you.